YouTube, it's Life with Ty, and this year I decided to do Vlogmas, and right now I'm on my way to Candleland, Miami, and we're gonna see how this goes.
I'll have a deluxe chicken sandwich, please.
Menu, our waiver, and the scale, and now we're just waiting for the staff. Oh, and here are the options for the vessels, and these are the options for the fragrances.
So go ahead and fill in your full name, the date, which is again December 2nd, 2020, and your email, which is going to be on our
okay, so now is the time to pick our scent. I personally want a Christmas scent, so I'm going towards the snickerdoodle. I'm going to smell that. If not the snickerdoodle, I'll probably do apple spice, or where is it, sandalwood, this one. Let me smell them. Okay, so I didn't know we were able to choose from the seasonal fragrances, but I'm definitely going to choose one of these. The first one is cinnamon and vanilla, the second one is sugar plum, and the last one is Christmas Eve. I bet this one smells like trees. Okay, so I ended up choosing Christmas Eve, and my mom ended up choosing midnight jasmine. And I'm not sure for the vessel menu. I think I'm going to either get that gold one right there, the white one, or yeah, I don't want silver, so who knows? Probably either gold or... Oh, that green looks so nice. Okay, so although this green looks very nice for Christmas tree, if I'm using the candle vessel over, I definitely want this gold. The next thing she had us do was get our warning sticker and name it. We could have put anything, I chose to put this. Okay, so now we're gonna get the wick, and then we're going to put the straw on top of the wick.
Oh, the darkest one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, I was just making sure.
Yeah, the stuff. Just peel it.
I don't want the sticky thing to come off.
No, it's not.
Oh, I see it.
Can you see the little sticky side?
Yeah.
Put it in there.
And once you place all three wicks inside of your vessel, grab your Sharpie and just press it on the base of the wick just to make sure it like stays and sticks on firmly.
Yeah.
And rain. And then go ahead and grab your empty glass beaker and place it on top of the scale.
So this one?
Yes. Place it on top and then press the T down here in the bottom just to tear out the weight. Make sure that you have put the glass beaker on top of it and then you press the T down below. You should be seeing 0 ounces.
Oh, that's a lot.
From the bottom when you're pouring in your wax, and you can clean up your mess when it comes to the towel. And then when you are passing the hot pitcher to your partner, always place it on the table first so they can grab it by the handle. Never wave hot pitchers in the air just because other people are gonna obviously grab it from this pitcher and it's gonna be way too hot for them to touch. Other than that, we will be measuring 11 ounces of wax. So once you receive your hot pitcher, go ahead and start pouring until you get 11. And of course, same thing goes for the wax. If you over pour, just pour back into the wax pitcher and you can go over by 20.20. So if you get to 11.20, that's fine.
What she said about that?
11.20.
Pour your fragrance into the wax. That was all for Candleland Miami. I hope you guys like this vlog. Please like, comment, subscribe, and share. And thank you for watching. Bye.